we paint the town. And all that jazz, I'm gonna rouge my knees.
Guys, it's Ashley and welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I decided to recreate Velma Kelly's makeup look from the iconic musical movie Chicago. At first, I saw some pictures of her on the internet and also on this website where you can look some characters with like whatever size length hair they have. I mean, mostly looking at short hair though. One's because my hair is short currently, and one that was Velma Kelly, and I thought, well, it's brownish a little, but then I tried to look, everywhere to see if it was truly, black, and there's one, Amazon, website for, a wig, that's kind of Velma Kelly-esque, and the color was black, so I was like, okay, I guess I'm doing Velma Kelly. Also, I did not know, the movie when it first came out would be 19 years, I wish I'd done this on the 20th anniversary, but whatever, maybe I might do Roxy on their 20th anniversary, I don't know, we'll see if I can find a blonde wig that's styled like hers, so yeah. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, thumbs up if you do, and also it's kind of freezing in my house, so that's why I'm wearing this cute dog pink robe. But anyways, let's get started.
Starting the skin, I'm using the LA Powder Soothing Face Primer, both in the white shade and the green shade. I'm using the green all over my face, mostly to cover up the acne redness I have, and the white mostly on my cheeks and nose area, and also on my forehead as well. I want to give this Becca Cosmetics foundation a try because I've never tried Becca Cosmetics. I also heard about them shutting down a little while back, so I decided to give this a try. It's a really nice full coverage foundation. I'm just applying it all over my face, and I wish they didn't shut down because of pandemic reasons, because I would totally buy this again. I could skip some concealer for this look, but I still have a little bit of acne scars that were still peeking through, and I wanted to add a little bit of this Urban Decay All Nighter concealer just to cover them up, and also adding a tiny bit under my eyes. Next, prep your eyes with the eye primer. I'm using the Pure Cosmetics Eye Polish in shade Satin, and you'll notice I skipped some powder during the tutorial. I didn't forget it or anything like that. It's just because we're going to be using the black eyeshadow, and black eyeshadow is known to fall out, so I thought I would skip powder for this look for now. But anyways, I'm taking the light cream shadow from my Confusion face palette. I'm just using it as a base all over my lids by applying over the lid and all the way up to my brow bone. Next, I'm taking this matte black eyeshadow right here and just applying it to the crease area. It kind of created like a little cut crease kind of look. It also fades this to the cat eye wing, or like a tense V, some people call it, and I'm using this little, like, one of those play cards right here to get the shape. And I did try to use a little bit of concealer to clean up the wing a little bit because I did mess up a lot. Now I'm doing something a little bit different. I saw someone else trying to recreate the look on their blog or something like that. But I'm taking a little bit of setting spray from Cover FX and dipping it into the matte black eyeshadow again that we used in the crease, and just packing it all over my lids. Now I'm taking this gold eyeshadow right here and just applying this to the brow bone. Now I'm using this LA Colors eyeliner pencil in black and using this to line my bottom lash line and also applying it to my waterline and also use it to tight line as well. Going back to this black eyeshadow we used, I'm applying it to the bottom lash line to smudge it out a little with the black liner pencil to make it as a worn-in kind of look. And next, I'm going to be curling my lashes, and before I apply any mascara, I'm going to be popping on some Ardell Wispy Lashes that I meant to use for my upcoming Mal from Missy Scent tutorial, but I tried to find the exact pair of lashes that someone used to recreate the look on their blog, but I couldn't find it, and I think they're discontinued now. So I'm using these Wispy Lashes from Ardell, and I'm just applying the only duo glue that I trust and use. Applying it to the strip of the lash, letting it dry, and just going to be popping them onto my lashes with some tweezers and adjusting it a little. No, not chewing. Popping. So I said to him, I said, you pop that gum one more time. And he did. So I took the shotgun off the wall and I fired two warning shots into his head. And for mascara, I removed the W7 Absolute Lashes mascara. I'm just applying it to my top lashes and my bottom lashes. Now all the blackness is done, let's set with some translucent powder from NYX.
I met Ezekiel Young from Salt Lake City about 2 years ago, and he told me he was single, and we hit it off right away.
For blush, I'm with this hot coral pink color right here. I'm just popping that right onto my cheeks. We'd have dinner, and then I found out. Single, he told me. For bronzer, I'm with this light bronzer color right here, and the only thing didn't look like she had any a lot of contouring going on, or like at least some color. But I have noticed in this scene that her cheekbones look a little sculpted or something like that. So I took this light bronzer and kind of underneath my cheekbones, and also to make my nose look a little bit like Catherine's, I'm gonna contour my nose up a little bit to make it like hers by applying the same bronzer down the sides of my nose, and what else am I doing? Oh yeah, under the tip and also across the nose tip to make it like hers.
Now I'm standing in the kitchen, carving up the chicken for dinner. Minding my own business, in storms my husband.
And to complete the contour illusions, I'm using this white eyeshadow right here to apply it to the nose tip and the nose bridge. And for brows, I use this Pixie by Petra Natural Brow Duo in the shade Soft Black. I'm just going to be filling my eyebrows, and I'm also using the gel side to set the brows in place. For lips, I'm using the same lip liner that you see a lot of some of my red lip tutorials, and it's Wet n Wild Perfect Pout Gel Lip Liner in Red the Scene. I'm just be lining my lips and then filling them in. And for the actual lipstick, I decided to go with the MAC's Iconic Russian Red Lipstick. I'm just be applying that to my lips, and I always wanted to try it. This is the lipstick from MAC, and as you can tell, I just dropped it. And there's the finished Velma Kelly look.
My husband Charlie traveled around with us. Now for the last number in our act, we did these 20 acrobatic tricks in a row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 splits, spread eagles, backflips, flip-flops, one right after the other. So this one night before the show, we're down at the hotel.
Hope you guys enjoyed this Velma Kelly inspired makeup look. And as for hair, what I did, I know like in some scenes the bangs were kind of like up to here, but I saw some pictures where it looks like they were side bangs, so I took this side of my hair and just like took a bobby pin and tried to make myself have some fake bangs like this sort of. And also as for other videos I have planned, of course there's Yuhora that I have planned, and of course Mal from Missy Sense, because my dog I did color my hair in this purple color that you guys can see currently. I don't know if it's purple to you guys, but the box said it was a dark, intense violet, but some people said it was more red, or some say it was red. Let me know who you guys see What colors you guys see? Do you see like a purple violet color? Do you see more red? Let me know in the comments. And also, I still have a couple those two wigs I bought back in October that I still haven't used yet. So I might do Aurora with the like Aurora from Maleficent with the light blonde wig, and maybe another Barbie tutorial because like the recreating the 70s Malibu Barbie, because I still have these Pure Cosmetics Barbie collection stuff that I haven't used yet. Well, I did use the blush palette right here when I was out for a camp retreat with my dad back in October, but I have not used the eyeshadow palette yet right here, or even the gloss yet. I'm dying to try the gloss. I might do a half-half situation with the Pure Cosmetics set. Barbie collection and this Morphe Matty Ziegler imagination palette that I got recently at Marshall's. Because the shades in here are kind of quite similar to the ColourPop Barbie collection that came out recently. So I might do half and half or just use the Pure Cosmetics Barbie collection. I don't know. We'll see. And also, maybe, I don't know. Let me know in the comments if you want me to recreate the cover art on the Morphe Matty Ziegler imagination palette right here. Let me know if you want to see that. If not on here, maybe I can do it on TikTok. I don't know. We'll see. Yeah, make sure you're also following on my other social medias. And then I'll see you guys for the next video. Bye!